This program will take an adult count, so how many adults in your party, how many children in your party, and then we'll calculate a total price for the whole group. And a couple of things I want to point out here is the constants. So almost like declaring a variable, double adult price. We go ahead and make an assignment, so we do the equal sign, and we set the adult price is equal to 10.25, and we make that a constant with the keyword CONST, which stands for constant. So constant double adult price. And what that means is every time the compiler sees this word throughout the program, adult underscore price, it's going to substitute in the value 10.25 or $10.25. We do the same thing for child price. We declare a constant, 675. One of the things this does for us, it makes us nice and easier to read our program when we look at our assignment statements down here. One drawback may be if we ever wanted to change the price of a ticket, we would have to change our program. In other words, we would have to come in and modify this and say, well, instead of 10.25, we want it to be 10.50 now. And recompile the program. If we change the source code, then we have to retranslate it or recompile it. Okay, I'm going to put that back to 10.25. Notice the other thing we have here during the calculation, we kind of broke it down into steps. So we have these intermediate variables here, or temporary variables, where we're saying we're taking the adult count times the adult price is an adult total. We don't use this variable for input or output, but it's kind of an intermediate calculation stage. So we calculate the adult total and the child total separately, and then we use our last calculation or assignment statement to get the total price for the grand total. Okay, and so this is pretty straightforward output statement. Your total is, we try to put a dollar sign in front of it to make it look nice. That'll almost work. Let's compile and run this, and how many adults, we'll say 2, and how many children, let's say 4, and it almost works out for us, but our total is $47.5, which is 50 cents, but we really want to get that 0 in there, so let's look at some formatting. For formatting, we're going to need to include another library, so I'm going to do another include statement. Okay, if I can type that right. Okay, and we'll come down here. Before we do our output, we're going to add a couple of formatting statements in here. So I'm going to add a cout statement. Okay, and it's going to send it to the cout device, but it's not actually going to show anything on the screen. It's just going to be formatting for how many decimal places. And this is the flag. We need to set this flag iOS :: fixed, meaning fixed number of decimal places. Okay, and we'll do one more to set the number. So we'll set precision to 2 decimal places. And if we wanted 3, we would make that 3. But we'll make it 2 for right now. And you just have to set that once for the whole session. So even if I have more outputs, they're all, from this point on, going to be formatted to 2 decimal places. Okay, let's check that and make sure it worked. We're going to compile and run this again. We'll use the same numbers. We had 2 adults, 4 children. And this time you see it forces it out to 2 decimal places. So we end up with $47.50.